Hello. Welcome to another module in this online course, Strategy and Introduction to Game Theory. So we are looking at the Bayesian second prize auction, and we have derived the Nash equilibrium of the Bayesian second prize auction, right? And we have said that each player bidding is true valuation, B1 equals B1, B2 equals B2 is the Nash equilibrium for this second prize auction. Let us now derive the expected revenue of this second prize auction. So let us derive the expected revenue of the Bayesian second prize auction. Now the Nash equilibrium is B1 equals V1 and B2 equals V2. Now observe, if V1 is greater than or equal to V2, then we have, then it follows that since B1 equals V1 and B2 equals V2, we have B1 is greater than or equal to B2. Therefore, player 1 wins and pays the second highest bid. Therefore, P1 wins and pays second highest bid, that is B2 equals V2, right? So if V1 is greater than or equal to V2, then the payment to the auctioneer or revenue to the auctioneer is V2. If V1 is greater than or equal to V2, revenue equals V2, revenue to the auctioneer equals V2. On the other hand, if V2 is greater than V1, then B2 is greater than B1, player 2 wins, player P2 wins and pays the second highest valuation, that is V1. Therefore, the revenue equals V1. So, what we are seeing is something very simple. If V1 is greater than or equal to V2, then the revenue to the auctioneer is V2. On the other hand, if V2 is greater than V1, that is valuation 2 is greater than valuation 1, then the revenue to the auctioneer is V1. Based on both these observations, we can conclude that the revenue for the auctioneer in this two player Bayesian second prize auction is the minimum of the valuations V1, P2. Therefore, 1 can conclude that the revenue to the auctioneer in this Bayesian second prize auction is the minimum of V1, V2. Therefore, what we can conclude is that the revenue to the auctioneer is the minimum of V1, V2. Remember, we also assumed that these valuations V1, V2 are distributed as independent random variables uniform with uniform probability density function in the interval 0 to 1. So V1, V2 are independent and they are distributed as uniform random variables in the interval 0 to 1. Now let us ask the question, what is the probability that the minimum of these two random variables lies in the interval v plus dv? So what is the probability that minimum of v1 comma v2 lies in v comma v plus dv? What is the probability that the minimum of these two random variables v1 comma v2 lies in the interval v comma v plus dv? We can analyze this again similar to the first price auction scenario. Remember, there we had considered the maximum of v1 comma v2. Now we are considering the minimum of v1 comma v2. Well, this occurs in two scenarios. In case 1, when v1 is the minimum, that is v1 is less than or equal to v2, therefore v1 lies in the interval v comma v plus dv, that is it lies in this infinitesimal interval v to v plus dv, and v2 lies to the right of v1, v2 lies in v plus dv comma 1. So the first case is where v1 is the minimum and v1 lies in the interval v to v plus dv, and v2 lies to the right of v1, that is in this interval v plus dv to 1. The probability of this, so therefore probability of this event equals probability v1 lies in or belongs to the interval v plus dv times the probability v2 belongs to the interval v plus dv comma 1. We said since these are uniform random variables distributed uniformly in the interval 0 to 1, the probability that it lies in any particular interval is equal to the length of the interval. Therefore, the probability that v1 lies in v to v plus dv is equal to the length of the interval dv times the probability v2 lies in v plus dv to 1 is the length of the interval 1 minus v minus dv. So therefore, the probability is equal to dv times 1 minus v minus dv. Now this term dv here is small in comparison to v, so I can neglect this since these are infinitesimal num quantities that we are talking about, and therefore that probability is equal to 1 minus v dv equals 1 minus v dv, right. So the probability that the minimum lies in v to v plus dv, we are analyzing it by splitting into two cases. One is v1 is the minimum and v1 lies in the interval v to v plus dv, and v2 lies to the right of v1, that is in the interval v plus dv to 1. Similarly, we can consider the other scenario we can consider the other scenario. What is the other scenario? The other scenario is v2 less than v1. V2 belongs to the interval or lies in the interval v to v plus dv, and v1 lies to the right of v2, that is v plus dv to 1, right. So we are considering the other scenario where v2 is the minimum of v1 comma v2, and v2 therefore lies in the interval v to v plus dv, since we are saying the minimum must lie in the interval v to v plus dv, and v1 lies to the right of v2, that is in the interval v plus dv to 1. And therefore the probability of this is equal to the probability v2 lies in v to v plus dv times the probability v1 lies in v plus dv to 1. Again, we are saying that each probability, since these are uniform in the interval 0 to 1. The probability, each probability is simply the length of the interval. So this is equal to dv times 1 minus v minus dv. Again, since dv is infinitesimal, I can ignore it in comparison to the v in the second term. So this is again equal to dv 1 minus v. Therefore, now considering the two cases where v1 is less than or equal to v2 and v2 is less than v1, the net probability that the minimum of v1 comma v2 lies in the interval v2 v plus dv is given as 1 minus v times dv twice 1 minus v. So the net probability that the minimum of v1 comma v2 lies in the interval v to v plus dv is given as twice of 1 minus v times dv. Therefore, now we have the probability that the minimum lies in the interval v to v plus dv. If the minimum lies in the interval v to v plus dv, then the revenue to the auctioneer is equal to v. Remember, revenue to the auctioneer equals minimum of v1 comma v2. Since minimum lies in the interval v2 v plus dv, revenue to the auctioneer equals v. Therefore, expected revenue equals the probability times v, which is basically equal to twice 1 minus v dv times v, right. So, with probability twice 1 minus v into dv corresponding to the minimum of v1 comma v2 lying in this infinitesimally small interval v to v plus dv, the auctioneer gets a revenue of v. So, expected revenue equals twice 1 minus v into v dv. And now this has to be integrated corresponding to each infinitesimal interval of width dv between 0 and 1. So therefore, I have the integral 0 to 1 twice into 1 minus v into v dv, right. So I have this integral twice into v into 1 minus v dv between the limits 0 to 1, which is also the same as integral evaluated between the limit 0 to 1 twice v minus v square dv. So, this is equal to the expected revenue equals integral 0 to v twice v minus v square dv, which is also equal to twice, well, the integral of v is v square divided by 2 evaluated between the limits 0 to 1 minus v cube divided by 3 evaluated between the limits 0 to 1, which is twice into half minus 1 third, which is twice into 1 sixth, which is equal to 1 by 3. Therefore, what we are seeing is something that is very interesting. We are seeing that the expected revenue is equal to 1 third, and this is the same as the expected revenue, remember, of the first price auction. Remember, we looked at the Bayesian first price auction earlier in one of the previous modules, and there also we had seen that the expected revenue when the valuations were distributed uniformly in the interval 0 to 1 was 1/3. Therefore, what we have seen is the revenue of these two auction formats is actually equal. Although these are two very different auction formats, we are seeing that the revenue of these two different auction formats is equal. This is termed as the revenue equivalence principle. This is termed as the revenue equivalence principle. So what we are seeing is that across these different, irrespective of the format of the auction, we are seeing that the revenue to the auctioneer, that is the net revenue to the auctioneer, is equal across these different auction formats, and this is termed as the revenue equivalence principle. And this is a very important principle in auction theory, which says that irrespective of the auction format, the revenue to the auctioneer is always equal, and this is termed as the revenue equivalence principle. So what we have done so far is we have looked at the Bayesian second prize auction, we have derived the Nash equilibrium of the Bayesian second prize auction, that is each player bidding his true valuation, that is B1 equals B1, B2 equals B2 is the Nash equilibrium, the Bayesian Nash equilibrium of this second prize auction. And now we have also derived the expected revenue of the second prize auction, and we have said that the expected revenue is 1/3, which is same as that of the first prize auction, and this illustrates the revenue equivalence principle. Thank you very much.